Hi everything, I mean everyone, dear lecturers and all my friends. I'm Immanuel Gunaraj Alexander and 03DSV17F2013 is my metric number. Here I'll be presenting about the Larvish Tourist Center. Okay, Larvish describes something rich and luxurious, and this is given because of the rich design and the diversity of the building. Okay, Larvish Tourist Center welcomes all people, both locals and tourists, and it's located in the midtown of Alostar, Kedah. Alright, as you know, Tourist Center here is for information of trail maps, campsite, hotels, latest event which is happening in Kedah or in the city. And then it's a place where you can gather information about tourist attraction. Okay, next is the building design based on human-centered design, which is the specialty design for emotion, social security and accessibility. The design idea of this was made from cuboid, which is three section, and from that Y section, I split it into six separate building by itself. Okay, and the design concept I've used is sound wave. By sound wave, I mean the wave of it, the curve wave. The curve wave are meant to reflect sound from entering the building. And the case study I've done is Tourist Information Center, Postojna, and it's the year of the building is 2014. Okay, the next is a precedent study is made. I studied about Norman Robert Foster, and the materials he always uses are glass structure and steel. Principle he always uses symmetry, asymmetry, irregular gradation, and geometry. Okay, the targeted users based on my study, I've targeted around 10% of kids, 35% of teenage, 40% of young adults, and 15% of elders. As you can see, there are the key plans and location plans by the side. And I've done an analysis of strength, weakness, opportunity, and threat based on the studies. And I've already listed out the synthesis, which I will put in my and by building the building. Okay, this is an existing site. There's a site plan and there's a site planning on the right hand side. I've listed about site zoning, site bubble diagram, site entrance, and building orientation. And there's lastly the site section. Okay, moving on, I'll be going to my ground floor plan. Ground floor plan, there I've listed the spaces, which are lobby, tourist information center, kiosk, internet kiosk, interactive galleries, souvenir shop, book cafe, bicycle renting hub, control renting hub, multi-purpose, prayer room, disability toilet, normal for male and female, storeroom, and the services are control room, switch room, and HD room. Meanwhile, on the first floor, there's a play area for kids, backpackers lodge spot, outdoor seating, book cafe, mini theater, open area, utility room, staff room, working area, and meeting rooms. Okay, there's the roof plan by the left hand side, and I've listed out the metric diagram on the right hand side. Okay, there's a typical section plumbing diagram, special detail of the gutter, which I've used, and I've also used ETFE cushion foam in the entrance of the building, which is in white color. And then I've also listed the rain screen facade, which is the red and white color by the side of the buildings. And lastly, down here, I've also made a section A and B. Okay, as for the elevation also, I've made four elevations. And there are perspective when it's raining, inside interior of the office, the LTC logo, and the souvenir shop. Okay, lastly, about the green building which I've rated here, there are water efficiency, energy efficiency, and indoor environmental quality. So I've also listed out number 1 until number 8. There are water saving fittings, human ease or accessibility, rainwater harvesting, window panel, solar panel, acoustic panels, and harvesting natural light. And lastly, the green roof. So there are numbers there, as you can see. This partly of what we have designed. We are mainly to design. And that's all for today. Thank you so much.